at the farewell function, he can pull out all the stops, and then we can arrange for media coverage, etc., etc., for maximum publicity. But thank you, Mr. Masolani. Mr. Masolani is my colleague at the Sesotho Literary Museum. So we are next door neighbors in this building. Thank you.
Dames en heren, I almost said goeiemiddag. Is dit steeds goeiemiddag? Ek het eintlik my Afrikaans by my kantoor agtergelaat, want altyd as ek moet kom praat, ek moet bietjie dink. And when I do that, now I have to recollect. And but we have demanded where we are seated that we needed to say something in appreciation of the life well lived. We felt that it will be a great omission if you wouldn't come and appreciate. I know we're still gonna see a lot by the time you do our farewell functions, which I think is not even gonna happen because we are in denial and we are making arrangements that he can't near us knee. So I'll try by all means just to be brief. Ek was eintlik 'n bigste Afrikaans spreker baie jare gelede. Ek het eintlik by Klokkeland groot geword en partykeer het ek by die plaas gekeer en een keer ons het beeldung gesteel. Dit was die draad en dit was die muur. En ons kom van hier die muur af, dan vat ons die drommel, klim ons op om daar bo die beeldung uit te plek. En een dag het die eienaar van die plaas my hand gevat van die kant af. So sê hy, Jannie, ek gaan daar kom. En as ek net daar by hom is, dan gaan ek sê, los hem Jannie, ek het hom. So I was a good listener, and I listened, and I started practicing. Los hem Jannie, ek het hom. Los hem Jannie, ek het hom. Los hem Jannie, ek het hom. By the time he was almost net healed, dan praat ek in die stem van die ANA. Los om Jani, ek het hom. Then Jani had me, you know, gelos. Then I, you know, it was nice because you had to learn Afrikaans in that uncalled for behavior. Coming to the present, ladies and gentlemen, we are grateful that you have had Ntate Otto working with us. I remember when I came here in 2006, the late Major Ensley said to me, you know, with Ntate Otto, if you write to him an email and say to him that Otto, this and this and this in two lines, he's going to respond appropriately, follow up, but he's going to give you two volumes of 100-page documents just to explain to you exactly what he meant. So you must always be prepared to listen and be able to read. And that is why he may not have realized that all the ways, the footprints that he has had, the love of weight, the love of books, the love of writing has basically rubbed off all of us, that we look back and say, here is the book working all the time. And if you could really recollect all the ways that he penned over the years, I'm sure you can agree with me that we can have volumes and volumes of hundreds of books out of all of that. And for me, I know that we were saying, I'm not going to talk about work much, but we said, everybody else must take a leaf out of Ntate Otto's wisdom in terms of writing proposals and submissions. You know, when he writes a submission, that submission can only turn back if there is any agenda. But mostly it will be so comprehensive, elaborate, and straight to the point, and it will even give you the other front from that day, and it will date back to 25 years ago, probably before you were born. So that's how brilliant he has been. And we want to say that Otto, 65 is but nothing. You're still a spring chicken, I know. And you can tell from how somebody walks. I have never seen him dragging his feet like a Gazmufana, Vanier Hanos is too. Me, all the time, he's always in the rush. And I also want to ask the family, especially Mema Liebenberg, I said brief, talk to him. I did a lot of talking to him for the past 2 days, and I told him that your health comes first. Don't touch anything that has to do with work. Just go home. enige ding sal volg. So he would still feel like, I'm not feeling well, I need to do this, but okay, maybe I can postpone going to the hospital because I need to drive to Cape Town and come back. I said, you can't do that. That's the love of work, that's the love of life for somebody who's always full of life. And we would like to say happy birthday, that we really appreciate that, and you have made us grow inside. But there's a leaky vat egg vet that is bayer, what is the
word?
Leaf, yeah, the leaky leaf. Actually, this song is a beautiful song that is normally led by one of the song beds here in our institution. So they asked to sing that thing, it will take just 2 seconds. And most of the time, you'll hear that from the basses and the altos and the tenors, they have not practiced. Only the lead singer knows the lyrics, and we know the melody. So don't judge us harshly. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together in celebrating the world and the life well lived, as we say happy birthday to Ntate Otto Liebenberg, but in this case, led by the songstress Mebetha Dikgetsi, plea from Africa. She will come with the entourage, but if the entourage does not come, then we'll sell the native Komdun. Come stand here, sir, please. She's from Italy. And this one is from a place in Mafuat. And then the lady here is from France. Actually, he lived in Netherlands for some time. And over to you, ma'am.